we find it necessary. We know we will win. We have confidence in the victory of good over evil.
Alex Dow. Alex Dow. Hey, everybody. Thank you so much. I just need you to know that the first time I ever saw a stage dive in my life, first time I ever saw a stage dive in my life, I'm pretty sure it wasn't just nonsense. I'm pretty sure it wasn't just, you know, simply about, you know, demonstrating how cool you are and how much air you can get. I took it seriously, and I went to a Bane show, and I gave my first stage dive ever. Nobody caught me. And I felt like I was a part of something, again, more than just like what those dickheads in the locker room were always fucking doing. And that's how I wanted it to be, and it wasn't always like that in the scene. But I want you to know that it's a sacred offering in my eyes. To whatever this weird tribal world we have here in what we call punk and hardcore. We got a lot of old friends here tonight who supported this band when fucking nobody gave a shit. And they mean everything to us. And you may not know them, but they're wonderful people. They're the type that will put on for people who they think got something special going on, and they help them feel like they got something special going on. And so, this next song, a little bit of an instrumental, is for them and for you, especially if you believe in the nobodies of the world. This one's for the dancers! This one's for the pitters! And the stage divers! just the greatest feeling to be with your friends, to be creating, and to be alive. Make no mistake, all the cars, the nice houses, they're nothing against hitting the road with your best friends.
Give him a flower.
not be too visible to you, but my thinking was if you were taking pictures from that angle, you would see something in that corner right next to the great PhD logo. And I want to properly salute the guy that just got this band when no one gave a shit about it. A proper salute. His name was Jimmy Flynn, and he was Boston Hardcore, and he is Boston Hardcore forever.
My best friend died in my fucking arms yesterday. And this fucking scene was everything to him. It was everything to me. This dude was the fucking living blood of what it means to be fucking true from your heart. You wanna talk stage dives? This motherfucker broke his back 15 years ago, stage diving off a fucking cliff into the ultimate fucking crowd, you know what I mean? And he told me, he's like, dude, if I look you could walk tomorrow, I wouldn't do that shit again. And he's a fucking warrior. This is for Michael Chops Gray. That motherfucker was my brother. He was a warrior. He was a fucking warrior. His name installed a catheter every time he had to take a leak. Like, he would not let people take his independence from him. He wouldn't go to the hospital. He didn't want to. Like, as far as he was concerned, they're trying to kill you. And they are trying to kill you. They're trying to kill fucking all of us.
Throw down for Mike!
This motherfucker. My brother, this whole show, I just wanted to give him a shout out. I have nothing really to offer you guys, but thank you. I love all of you. This fucking place has raised me. This is my fucking home. I don't know anywhere else where I can fucking meet it as far as I have. So I just wanted to say fucking I love you, Chops, dude. That dude is the fucking everything, man. Like, he's everything. Thank you. Sorry for interrupting.
No, if you can't. You can't get up and express yourself in a place and let the world know that your heart is bleeding. Find a different place where it will accept you. That's exactly what this song's about. I wrote it walking around the streets of Boston in October, thinking about all the things falling the fuck apart. We got to win. You're hell in my life. great friend of mine posed a question to me and to the hardcore scene. And that was, why should I love a world that won't love me back? And I heard that not as some fucking cool mosh part. I heard that as a real question about human nature and about the fucking hardest thing that we can do. And that is to love your enemy. I still fixate on that question because I look to history for inspiration, and it is there, but sadly, the darkness seems to overshadow the light most of the time. And I find it very difficult to find the lone people who really know how to do something, not revolutionary, but evolutionary to the species. And that is to love your enemy and to hate not, as Izzeldin Abolish says. If you don't know who he is, look him up and then try telling me about hatred and love. In the words of Izzeldin Abolish, I shall not hate, and I shall not be a part of an historical continuity to hate and hate and hate and hate. I want that cycle broken. And if you find hatred sexy, please know I find it disgusting. I shall love a world that won't love me back. This is a song I wrote for my brother Miles and Flynn, my greatest hero, who has shown me the true nature of our species. To endure the hardship of life's horror. We're a band called Half Heart from Boston, Massachusetts. And this is the sweet